My name is Annette Valle, and I'm from Victoria, Texas, and Victoria College. This is my story, and I'd like to say thank you to Skip for inviting me. I'm already getting emotional, and I'm sorry. And I'd like to thank all y'all that helped me feel so comfortable here. I didn't feel left out or out of place, and I want to thank everybody for that. This is my story. Miss Turner, my seventh grade teacher, math teacher, she lives in my head. I haven't seen her in more than 30 years, but I can still picture her on that day when I went to her desk at the front of the room. Her skin was fair and her hair was brown and long. Her eyes were hazel, and I can see her elbows on a big wooden desk, her eyes staring off into a distance, clicking her nail finger against the nail finger of her thumb. When I asked her to help explain the map, she turned and waved my paper at me and told me I was too stupid to learn the map. All these years later, I can still hear her words. I have no idea why you come to my class, Annette. You're never going to pass math. You're just stupid. Then she dismissed me with a wave of her hand. You see, I grew up in Houston, Texas, in the 70s, where college was something that rich, smart people did. It wasn't for a poor, Valle Hispanic child living there in this Valle. In our neighborhood, there were no talks about going to college. Conversations were about drug dealers, drive-bys, and the latest girl that got beat by her husband. Our biggest goal was to survive. Like many of my friends, I dropped out of school. I got married at the age of 15 and had two children by the time I was 17. After my brother got his GED in the military in the 80s, he talked me into getting a GED. That diploma qualified me for a higher paying job, working in a chemical plant as a security guard and loading ATM machines. But they were laboring jobs that required physical labor, and I didn't like them very much anymore. Now, fast forward my life to 2005, and that's when I was diagnosed with rheumatoid arthritis. The doctor said I couldn't do the work at a physical job anymore, and I had become eligible for a rehabilitation program that offered me the opportunity to attend college. When I started my first semester, at the age of 46, I was overwhelmed and scared. The campus seems huge, and I was intimidated by all the young students and the academic requirements that I didn't understand. The teachers, when they said, "Here's your syllabus," but I had no idea what a syllabus was. My English teacher told us to do our research paper in MLA format, but I had no idea what that meant. I didn't ask because I figured everyone else knew, so I pretended I knew too. I walked around the campus with my head down and I watched the cement. If I had a problem and someone didn't ask, "Can I help you?" I would just figure it out on my own. One of my courses was called Strategic Learning, where we read the on-course. In class, I learned to overcome my fears and accept every challenge placed before me. It helped me become armed with the belief that the choices I make and the strategies I use will determine what happens to me. I learned to combat the scripts in my head that were saying, "You're not smart enough, you can't do this, you can never be a good college student." I replaced those negative thoughts with, "I can do this, I will do this, and whatever it takes to get the work done, only I can change my path." It's a good thing I had this class because I was also taking math. And Miss Turner was still in my head telling me I was stupid and I would never pass math. Instead of giving in like I had when I was in her class, I tried my newly learned strategics, and I, with determination, one thing I did was take an inspirational quote from the encores, and I wrote them down and placed them on my home wall workplace. When I feel like giving up, I read them out loud. Then I remind myself that I'm just as smart as my younger classmates, and I can accomplish my dreams just as well as they can. I'm doing whatever it takes, even if it means spending 40 hours in a tutoring center. Maybe I'll never be a math student, but I did pass that class with a B. I am now in my fourth semester in college, and I walk around the campus with my head held high. And when I see another student who's confused, I offer them help. I even use some of the on-course techniques to encourage other students who have the same obstacles I had. The course made me a stronger person, and it helped me change my life. Still, I get sad when I realize that I believed Ms. Turner for so long. I wasted a lot of years listening to her, criticizing me in my mind. And for a long time, I let her steal my thunder of achievement.